Showtime.
Right now, though, you are watching Delmarva Life, and we are stepping into St. Patrick's Day, if you will. We've got JJ Hester with us on Zoom today. How you doing, JJ?
Good. How are you doing, Katie?
Good. So you are, and do I call you an Irish dance teacher? That's what it is, right?
That's great. Yep. Irish dance teacher.
So tell me, I know Irish dance is not something everybody's into. How did you get into it?
Right. So my sister and my cousins were doing it when they were a lot younger. And I was actually almost 17 years old when I decided to try it. Mm-hmm. My sister and cousins, like I said, they were into it. They were involved in competitions. And I had seen River Dance, the show, and seen Lord of the Dance. And I decided I wanted to give it a try. And so I did. I went to a dance class, and I was a 17-year-old in there with all the younger students trying to learn the beginner basics, and just got hooked, I think, from day one.
What do you think it is about Irish dance? I mean, I know watching it, it's incredible, but what is it about, you know, doing it or even watching it that people love so much? It's extra special.
Right. So I think the music that goes with it ties everything together. And for me, like, anytime I hear that Irish music or the beat of that, I just always tapping my feet. And all the dancers I know that do Irish dancing is the same thing, or they start tapping with their fingers trying to make up steps to the music, because we just get hooked on it. But they go hand in hand. So without the music, it's still nice, but when the music comes on, it's fantastic.
Gets you right going. Now, you teach Irish dance too.
Yes, I do. I see about between 40 and 50 students a week. I teach at my studio in Millington, Maryland. Mm-hmm. And they're ages 4 and up. So we have some students who are really basic beginners, and we have some students who have worked their way up the ranks of competition. Some of them are college age students. So it runs the whole gauntlet.
I bet watching those 4-year-olds do this is amazing.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, especially when it sort of clicks in their mind that they figured out how to do the step, and trying to coordinate their legs to fit the music to the right speed is definitely interesting, but they do enjoy it.
Do you get extra excited for St. Patrick's Day?
Love it. I love St. Patrick's Day. It's like an amazing holiday. Like people do, but Christmas, Irish dancers love, you know, St. Patrick's Day, because they get to go out and perform for people. And my dancers just love sharing Irish dance with other people. So yeah, it's a really exciting time.
And you're doing an online performance for Caroline County, right?
Yep. So the Caroline County Arts Council, they receive some sort of grant that allows people to come into their district and into the Caroline County, and for different months. So we had Black History Month speakers, and now we're in Irish Heritage Month speakers. And that became me, I guess. And they found out I did Irish dancing, and they were like, would you do this project for us? And so we wrapped it up last week, and it's about to go out, I think, this week for St. Patrick's Day timing.
Cool. Okay, so yeah. How hard is this to learn?
Well, when I did the Caroline County Arts Council thing, it was just a little bit of a basic step that I could teach. And I made it so that it was a step that I could teach to a kindergartner, but also someone who's grown could learn it as an adult. So it's going to be basic to learn it, but as you sort of progress, the steps obviously get harder as you start to be more involved in it.
All right. I am fired up. I want to try it. So you're going to let me try, right? Teach me some things?
Yes, absolutely. All right. So I'm going to teach you a light jig, an Irish dance light jig.
All right. Here we go.
All right. So the first thing you do in Irish dancing is keep your arms in at your side, which is a little bit different from all other types of dance where they can move their arms and do what they want with them. In Irish dance, we keep them stiff to our side, and we're going to put one foot in front of the other. I typically do the right foot first. So we're going to put the right foot in the front, and the back foot will be the left foot. So you have your feet crossed. And I'm going to teach you something called a light jig. So for the light jig, you're going to bring your right foot up to your bottom. And as you bring it up, you're going to hop on the other foot. Perfect. But you want to try to keep those arms
in. Oh, my arms. Oh, that's right. Okay.
Try to keep those arms in. Good. And now we're going to go forward with the right foot. So put it in the front. Put it down in the front. Good. Now you're going to hop the left foot, which is in your back. It's going to go up to your bottom. Hop the left foot up to your bottom. Yep. Bring it to the front. Put it down.
I have heels on today, JJ, so that's why I'm a little bit of a mess. Okay.
And the right foot is going to go up to your bottom one more time. Hop it to your bottom right foot and bring it to the front. And as you put this one down in the front, you're going to count to 4. And it's going to be like a seesaw where the right foot steps onto it, the back foot steps onto it, the right foot steps onto it, and the back foot steps. So it's like a 1, 2, 3, 4 motion. Yes.
Okay.
Perfect.
All right.
We'll try from the beginning. So arms in tight, right foot's in the front.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to hop it to my bottom. The right foot comes up to my bottom, and I hop on another foot, bring it to the front. You're going to step.
Yeah.
Good. Hop the left foot to the bottom. Step it to the front. And then when we hop the right foot to the bottom, we're going to do that 1, 2, 3, 4. So right foot up, bring it to the front and count your 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You're doing great.
Hey, there we go.
Want to try the next piece?
Yeah, let's do one more piece. I'm here for it.
Next piece, we go backwards. So we do the same pattern, but we're going to bring the right foot to the back, and we have to hop it to the back.
Okay.
So I'm going to lift it up, and I'm going to bring it behind. So the right foot comes to the back. Good. And then I'm going to bring the left foot behind, hop it back.
Ooh, I like this.
Good. And then the right foot goes to the back this time, and I count the 4. So I bring the hop foot, the right foot to the back, hop back, and you're going to put it down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Awesome.
All right.
That was really, really good.
That is cool stuff, JJ.
Yes, you did a great job with that.
I feel good about it. I feel like if I did a little more practicing, perhaps for like the next year or so, I'll look somewhat good at it.
Better, yeah.
Well, cool. So I'm sure people would rather see you dance than me. So coming up next, you're going to stick around. You're going to do a performance for us, right?
Absolutely.
Sounds good. We will be right back. Before the break, we introduced you to JJ Hester. He is an Irish dance teacher, and he's also a PE and health teacher at Lockerman Middle School in Denton. Now, he taught me a light jig, which I feel good about. I need to do some work on it, but that's okay. But now we are gonna let you see his skills. JJ, what are you gonna be, what's this dance called, JJ?
It's called a treble reel.
All right, we're gonna let you take it right away. Your legs just moved so much faster than mine in the light jig.
Yes.
So you must be at, like, that must already get you out of breath, right?
Heart rate up to about 207.
Okay, so what you just did, obviously you teach classes, so, like, do your kids dance, do the students dance that fast? Like, do you have some who can do that? And
yep, so I've got some students who are at that level that they can do those steps. And I have some students who are at the beginner level who will work their way up to that. And I've got some students who are in the middle level who are aspiring to get to there a little bit sooner.
Is it hard to get your legs to like move that fast? Like normally they're not moving that fast in every life. So I imagine that that's kind of the hardest part, is just like the brain leg coordination and all that.
That's how I teach PE. I come into the gym and we're ready to go. That's how I wake up. Go, go, go.
And do you have any, like, any dances you're working on or any dreams in the Irish step world that you want to do or anything like that?
No, you know what? I traveled all around the world with competitions. I did pretty well with those for myself. Mm-hmm. So my goal now is just passing the love of Irish dance to my students and then seeing them thrive in their competitions and stuff now that COVID's sort of allowing a little bit more competition to happen here and there.
You've already fired us up about Irish dancing, so that's good. Now, if anybody was watching this and they wanted to get a hold of you, maybe they were interested in classes, what's the best way to do that?
They can go to hesteracademy.com and they can contact me through there. We have ages 4 and up. We've got girls and boys in our studio, and we're happy to teach them some Irish dance.
Well, JJ, thank you so much. This, I don't know, I mean, I was already excited for St. Patrick's Day, but now I'm super fired up.
Well, you're very welcome. Thank you so much for having me on.
All right. Awesome. We'll talk to you soon.
Okay. Fantastic.